Good morning. It is October 27th. The county is meeting with PBA for their second wage reopener. I'm Crystal Dodura, County HR.
Nikki Powell, Labor Relations Manager.
Wes Moreno, County Administrator.
Bruce Bell, Chief Corrections.
Scott Nash, Commander, County Jail.
Jonathan Stuckey, Lieutenant, Scammy County Jail.
Floyd Dipple, Jail.
John Christopherson, Florida PBA.
Dustin Perazine, Scammy County Jail.
Jason Santos, County Work Annex.
Hey, good morning, guys. This really has nothing to do with the wage reopener. I just want to make y'all aware that we received this letter. Commissioners received that letter. Last week. I just want to make sure you all were aware of it. So there's been no action to be taken on. Just for your information. More love.
Kristen, I'm going to go ahead and forward you that letter that they're reviewing right now so you can see it.
Oh, I got it.
We got it.
Yeah. All right, so we left last meeting. I think we finalized the two-step progression. And then I guess you guys want to keep this meeting. And so I'll let you tell us what you have on your minds, and we'll see what we can do.
All right, thank you. First off, I'd like to thank you for sharing that with us. And we'll be chatting amongst ourselves.
Just wanted to make y'all aware that
we'll just and we do appreciate that. Thank you. We do have some articles that we would like to discuss, and they're interconnected with each other, so we'll go ahead and provide them to you all at once. The articles are 13, 17, and 21.
Yeah.
us about these before we caucus.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we can caucus and read them and come back. But you know, I know it'll take us a little while to read through them. So if there's anything you want to just say up front.
I suppose for 13, it's fairly straightforward. We're looking at basically getting a lot of these provisions back to where they were prior to the association coming over from the sheriffs to the Board of County Commissioners. We have basically laid out in 1302, just clarifying 10 hours of sick leave per month. Yeah, so we're allowing the conversion of, or we're proposing to allow the conversion of 40 hours of sick leave to annual leave on the anniversary date. This is something that the sheriffs do, and something that's pretty common practice in a lot of agencies. So, and it was prior to coming over from the sheriff's office, this was something that, it's my understanding, was done for these employees as well. So we'd like to propose that be practice going forward.
That's 13?
This isn't 13, okay. Yes. We'd like to increase the annual leave accrual rate for employees that are here beyond 5 years. And there's already the table that was in the current article, but for the employees that are beyond 5 years, we'd be increasing each step by 2 hours of accrual. We'd also be looking at increasing the total number of hours for maximum leave from 400 to 500. Again, this is something that the sheriff's office is able to do or has done, and we're trying to get back to where we were prior to the Board of County Commissioners.
Would you tie that to that of what the state allows to sell for retirement purposes? Is that one of the practical reasons to go back to the 5-4-5?
Yes, sir. I think we tried to get it last time, but I don't think we got that around to it.
We've also made a proposal regarding funeral leave. Again, this is all in 13. We've added sister-in-law, brother-in-law, aunt, uncle, and in-law, uncle-in-law. There is a provision that includes the officer's immediate household, but we've laid out certain other members that are included in there, just for clarity's sake. Now, this is in looking at holiday leave, and this is something that will be tied in with one of the other proposals that we're making. We'd be increasing the holiday leave that's accrued by the officers that are on 12-hour shifts to 12 and a quarter. And that is tied into the Article 17 that we'll be discussing. So if you'd like to caucus on that and come back, or if you'd like us to run through all of them and then caucus.
Can I run through them?
Starting on Article 17, we would propose to increase the 12-hour shift to 12 and a quarter-hour shift. This is to reflect what's already in practice. And it's my understanding that this has been something that's kind of been put in place with the day of rest that's included in Article 17. Our proposal would be to remove the day of rest if we can get these other provisions or these other proposals approved or agreed on. We'd be removing the day of rest. We think it makes things less complicated in terms of how leave is handled and how, I guess, everything's calculated, because it's been kind of an evolving process over the years as to how this day of rest has been handled. And if we look at the provision as is, it says it's to be reviewed upon each wage reopener. If we can figure out something that kind of works going forward that clears up that issue, and it doesn't necessarily need to be reopened every reopener, that might be a benefit for everybody. So, Yeah, so the rest of it will tie in with the next proposal. This will be Article 21, salaries. So what we've added is Section C, which indicates effective October 1st, 2022, excuse me. In addition to the two steps that were granted in the last meeting, we'd be proposing another three steps, increase to all covered employees. And this would, again, be in exchange for giving up that day of rest, which from a practical standpoint, there's less overtime that's required to have somebody fill that shift when an individual is off. So we believe this would be a benefit to the BCC as well as to our members. But again, we'd be happy to hear what your thoughts are on that.
Sure.
In addition to that, with the 12 and a quarter hour as opposed to a 12 hour shift, as of right now, it's my understanding that the practice is to have the employees on duty but only being covered for a 12 hour shift, whereas 15 minutes of that is considered a muster time that's rolled into day of rest. And if we're doing away with the day of rest, then the employees would all be paid for the amount of time that they're actually here at work. Again, cutting down on the required overtime by employees that are covering shifts, but kind of simplifying the process for everyone as we go forward.
So 85.75 hours scheduled,
every 2 weeks.
Paid OT at the 86th hour.
Anything over your normal schedule.
Which would be 85.75.
Basically like the DAs in terms of the 12.25. That's why we are asking for the holiday to match what the shift is. If you're on shift, you're required to take 12.25 hours off. So if you're earning holiday leave for that day, then it should correspond to their shift of 12.25 instead of 12. So with that proposal.
Just like the DAs.
Correct, just like the DAs.
All right,
anything else? That would be our proposals. We also had a couple points that we would just like to discuss in terms of practice. One of them being how the current leave accrual rate is based on a 26 pay period year, and the contract reads that it's yearly or it's annually, monthly. So like 8 hours a month, but it's split up over a 26 pay period.
That's actually no longer true. It is based on the software that we use. So in our old software, it was based on a 26 pay period. In our new software, it's based on hour per hour. So it's an hour per hour accrual. So all of the contracts and our policies state that it's 8 hours a month. And when you do the math, it does add up to that. But it's not given, here's your 8 hour block, because it's based on what our software can accommodate. So our software, our old EFIN software, can accommodate and accrue every pay period. Our new software actually does it hour per hour.
Okay. We'll have a quick discussion about that when we go into separate caucus.
Yeah.
And we'd also be open to considering a clarification of seniority for the officers in terms of and supervisors. And again, my apologies, I use officers, deputies, all of it. Clarification of seniority as it pertains to employment date or promotion date, and what the past practice has been, and how we've all kind of considered it, and what it would be going forward. So we
I don't believe there's any dispute between any way. I mean, it's the days that you were promoted to the current classification that you're in.
But
that's your
current
plan.
Language of the contract
right.
is by certification.
Right.
Which
doesn't allow for promotions.
Sure.
And that's the date that you put into that pay grade, that's your seniority in that pay grade, not your date of hire.
All right, anything else?
No, sir.
All right, we'll go talk about it.
And you're able to send a copy to Kristen?
Yes.
Yes. All right, Kristen, we'll call you when we get back into the room. Okay.
If she's got time,
you can send it to me, and I'll make sure she gets
it. Okay. I'm still. I have to get your.
All right, so we'll take a look at what was proposed, what you guys submitted. Start with the easy stuff, as far as the funeral leave and adding some of the family designations. We're pretty open to that. We'll bring you guys something to the table. As far as the day of rest, and we're running, you know, we just ran some rough numbers. To eliminate the day of rest and then pay our extra time work, it's going to cost us about $800,000. So what we'd like to do is, and those are just extremely rough estimates, so we'd like a little more time to actually do some more calculations and deciphering before we bring something back formally on the day of rest and the three steps and all, I know all that plays together, and see what our actual cost is and what our benefit is. And, so we will ask to schedule another session to bring something more definitive. Give us a little more time to run those calculations. As far as annual leave accrual, we're going to let keep that the same as standard throughout the county. And so as far as that goes, we're going to look to keep that the same as it is currently.
Is that on the annual leave?
Mm-hmm. Instead of going to 500, you get 400. And I'll let for the clarification, seniority.
Yeah, if you guys want to bring a proposed MOA together, or MOU, either one, reference that seniority clarity based off of classification as opposed to hire date. I think we're all in agreement with it. I mean, it is the date that you get promoted or certified. It is your seniority date for that grade. I don't think there's any disagreement in that. So if you guys want to form the document, next time we meet, we'll perform live. But we'll move forward, you know, with the rest of the planning that we have in place regarding the shift, using it under the understanding of your date of classification is your seniority date. So the date you got certified, the date you got promoted is your certified date, or is your seniority date in that grade. I think there's no disagreement with that.
Yeah, we have no problem drafting up something for our next session. So just to recap, for the funeral leave and the salaries provision, day of rest, there would be something that you'd like to do next time?
Yeah, we're going to take a more in-depth look at it. I mean, it's kind of ran some numbers off the hip, if you will, in there. But I want to be able to actually sit down and make sure we have everything encompassed, you know, before we bring the formal into the proposal.
What about the sick leave accrual of 10 versus 8?
No, we're going to keep the same as the rest of the time.
What about the conversion of sick leave to annual?
Same, anything regarding leave will be the same as the county policy is for the rest of the county.
Holiday leave.
That would be pending if we. Yeah.
Okay. So that's still open. Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know if you saw. It was just changing it to what's current practice about leave requests are submitted electronically. That's.
Yeah, I don't think there's gonna be an issue with that.
Yeah, that's just what we currently do because of UKG.
Yeah.
So we're just trying to clean that up to current.
Absolutely.
Everything else is just pending.
Then would we like to start looking at dates now?
Yep. What's that?
Your calendar.
I can see some of it, but not enough to know. Sometimes I like when
when Sharon and I look at it together, we can see what can be moved.
Gotcha.
I'd say between now and the 22nd of November, Wednesday is at 2 o'clock or a different day.
Wednesday's at 2 o'clock?
Noted.
What'd you say?
If we can avoid the 16th of that Wednesday, I'd appreciate it. No, I should be done. I don't know. Yeah, I should be done by 2 o'clock.
What about?
That's good.
Where are we now? Because I'll need at least a week to run.
Some Monday afternoon is good.
Numbers for you. Like November 2nd or November 9th. I'll go November 2nd. Have your commissioner meetings in the afternoons?
Not at 2. We want it 2 o'clock.
No more? Okay. Second or the 9th looks okay, then if that's the case. Kristen, the 2nd or the 9th, November 2nd or November 9th around 2 o'clock?
Yes.
Either or?
Yes.
Second works better for me.
Second.
Second.
Okay. You'll be here, right? I won't be here, so.
Yeah, I'll be.
Where are you going?
Well, yeah, because it's the.
I canceled that shit. I did. I got the credit card right here.
I know you do.
About the 7th.
The 7th.
What's his schedule? We'll try.
Oh, yeah, I didn't know. Monday. You mentioned Monday.
Monday. It's not going to be too bad.
Oh, my goodness. 7th?
I would be on the 7th that afternoon.
Yeah,
be one.
Yeah, I'm not available on 7th. Sorry.
Okay, 7th's not good.
Maybe I'll try.
I mean, you're out in front. Okay.
Monday afternoon.
No, they're not. That's not
good. I really on 7th. Sorry.
Oh, yeah.
They're so hard to get.
Yeah.
So, 16th?
I mean, we can make the 9th work.
I work on it.
You'll be there. You
should.
Free on the 16th.
We can make the 9th work.
He's free on the 16th. Actually, the 16th works better
for
him. Then are you guys all available the 9th?
They're
on the 16th.
I'm good. I work nights and things, so I'll be with the 9th.
And like I said, the 9th works for us.
Yeah.
I can do the 9th or the 16th.
What time
are those working?
2 o'clock.
2 o'clock on the 9th?
2 o'clock on the 9th.
I'll do it.
Yeah.
If I'm for one of the things I'm supposed to do, it'll be it.
Mm-hmm.
We do, but I'll just handle it until we get stuff.
I'll send an official invite when I get back to the office. Mm-hmm.
You'll care for that.
Yeah.
Okay.
I can work that day.
I'll go ahead and let you know you are approved. Can you see this room's there?
Step down.
They removed another this weekend.
Name? No one was ever meeting with us. We didn't. Their PBA president, I don't think, ever came.
It was Alan Miller. Alan was
here.
Yeah, he was here a couple times.
Yeah, he was around for two.
Skinny guy, gold face.
Prior to you getting involved, Nick, he was here a couple times.
Okay, I was going
to
say.
He sat next to me most of the time.
Well, for our union president meeting.
I'll be there.
It was me.
I had only ever called with Alan.
That's it.
Are we going to stop the recording, or y'all have anything else before we stop that?
No, I believe we have
it. No, we've got to stop that. Thanks.